tatyanukampyam susamikshamanam bhunyanu evatmakrito vipakam hridbhag bhupivirvidadha namaste jiveto muktipadesha daiva. Tatyanukampam susamikshamanam bhunjana eva atmakrito vipakam hridvag vapubhir vidada namaste jibeta bhakti pade sadayava. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupad told that slightest deviation from the track of your Guru Padma can ultimately throw you away from bhajan. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that the slightest deviation from the track of your Guru Padma can ultimately throw you away from Hari Bhajan. Actually, point is that apparently we cannot understand this point, how it is possible. Because when bonded soul taking shelter unto the lotus feet of Sadguru, usually when bonded soul going to take shelter unto the lotus feet of a Sadguru, that time they are not developing 100% inclination. Most of the case, in general case. But I already told, Dikha, this procedure is a long procedure through which you are going to get Kripa of Gurudev, not 100%, but some Kripa you are getting. And if you are sincere from heart, niskapat, then gradually you can go on developing your submission unto the lotus feet of Guru Padma. Someday you will have to satisfy this satisfaction 100%. The day you can prove that you are 100% inclined, 100% submission done by you, in that case you can get power, actual power of Hari Bhajan. Otherwise, because Guru Kipa is Chit Kipa, na? Sarv Shakti Kipa coming through Guru. So anyway, the more we are going to so our inclination unto the lotus feet of Guru Padpada, the more we can get power gradually. So, actually, apparently this sloka we cannot understand. How possible? There can be some difference between the opinion of Gurudev and disciple, some disparity. But point is that, if today you think a slight difference there from Gurudev, slight. But ultimately, if you cannot make up this difference through your bhajan, if you cannot make up this disparity, then ultimately, you are going to develop a big disparity. If you cannot make up, that's why in kirtan, you can remember, Guru Mukha Padma Bhakcho Hidayate Koriya Vikyo Arna Koriyo Muni Asha. Arna Koriyo Muni Asha, you cannot reserve any personal desire, anything personal. Mane, actually, when you are going to, totally harmonize with Guru Charan, then you can see all the desires of Guru Padma reflected inside your heart. Follow. Automatically. It's not artificial. When you are 100%, harmonized with Guru Padma, you can discover, my Guru Maharaj want to get it done by me. So I'll have to do. This way, this is the exceptional power of Sadguru. Sadguru externally sitting in India, Mayapur, but he can influence, he can give power to disciple. There are thousands of miles away. Maybe he is in America, in England. From here, Guru Padma. This is the secrecy. When I pray Vandana to Prabhupada and Gurudev, they automatically speak, go on speaking this way, they supply. So, aprakita sabda brahma you cannot manufacture. Aprakita sabda brahma you cannot manufacture. It's an automatic factor. But 100% you should have your aerial connection with that transcendental one. You should have your aerial connection with the transcendental world. Automatically, the Sabda Brahma can appear and start dancing in you. That you can remember, yesterday I was speaking the slope. Again, I can discuss them, maybe after some day, I can discuss. Very analytically, you can understand. How is possible? Really so? Yes. So, material oratorship. Merit material oratorship, you know, who can speak? Oratorship material is not equal to a devotee who can speak by the power of Guru Vaishnava. No, not same. It seems as almost same. He can also speak this way, but not that. So total harmonization, if done. In that case, all the desire of Prabhupad, Gurudev, you can get reflected inside your heart and you can get guidance accordingly. When you are not 100% inclined, in that case, maybe 80% inclined, still, that time you need a practical guidance, you know. You don't understand what I mean to say. When you are 80% bondage or 80% free, 20% bondage, still you need externally one Gurudev physically present to whip you. Hup, hup, two, hup. This way you need. And when you are 100% inclined, when you are totally harmonized, you can find guidance automatically coming. Now those who are material people, they can pick up some quarrel. Oh, why Maharaj? Gaurakishar Bhai, who is there to guide? Oh, you misunderstand me. Who is there to guide Keshav Goswami and Prabhupada gone? Who is there to guide Prabhupada? Don't try to put this kind of logic. When you are elevated up to that point, you can find all Guru Varga present. Guru Varga always present, they are guiding you, they are giving inspiration to do this seva, that seva, do seva. But in bonded condition, you need some pressure so that you can do seva. Automatically, bonded soul cannot do seva. So, the first thing is their sincerity. Sincerity at all not there, then never in life they can develop 100% inclination. Sincerity, man. That's why in Kirtan, we can find one thing that yogota vichare kichu nahi pai tomaro koruna saro. Follow. All there in Kirtan, but you cannot feel. That is the main problem. You cannot feel. Chanchal, always mind resting, restless. So, yogota vichare kichu nahi pai tomaro koruna saro. In morning time sura I am speaking. Evening time sura, not that different. Yogyata bhitare kichu na pai. If you are going to test me, what is your quality so that you have come to me to take diksha? Sadguru, if Bhakti Pramodpuri Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, you want to test me, what is the quality you have so that you are coming to get dibhogyan from me, then I am really disqualified. Follow? But one point is that they are totally merciful incarnation. Total. You know, Sigoro Korona Shakti, Vigrahaya Namastite. So they are merciful incarnation. So out of their mercy, their heart get melted. Okay, let me give a chance them. Maybe they can do bhajan. This way, Guru Padma giving chance. Actually, if he is going to test my quality, in that case I am not qualified. But not that quality can never come, not that. Because if sincerity is that, it is there from Guru Varga and Bhakti Mata, all The only thing you need is sincerity. All other quality can automatically come. Follow my point. Only the thing you need is your sincerity, niskapat. Then you can find from Gurudev automatically power coming. What is not possible for me, that is possible for me. Pangung langhayati girim. Pangung langhayati girim. A layman can cross river how? You think it's one kind of exaggerated philosophy. No, not exaggerated philosophy. Pangung langhayati girim. It's possible, 100%. So this way we can get power gradually and try to reconcile with Guru Padma ultimately. Up to the last moment of my life, at the time of death, if I am failed to reconcile with my Guru Padma, then there is problem. Follow. In that case there is problem. I will have to again come. So if you can harmonize totally with Gurudev, one thing I like to speak, very secret thing. I can reconcile with Guru Padma, in that case, total environment changing. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving indication that your mind, material mind is there, and you are always thinking, na, manipulating something. This mind is actually Chidabhas, not Chinmoy. With your mind there, inside, you have your mind, but it seems mind cannot be seen. You can see in your mind, but you cannot see. But mind is there. You can understand the activities of mind. But this Bhishya, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, mind is Chidabhas. Chidabhas mean? Not actually Chit, but Chidabhas. But when you are going to reconcile with Guru Padma 100%, we are going to carry out the order without any contradiction, without any argument, you are going to. In that case, automatically when devotee, sadhan siddha, they are going to do bhajan gradually, then you can find Krishna bhakti raso panad, deho daihika vishite, tesam panchabhautik devehupi, sachidananda rupota. Sachidananda roop, everything all. And first of all, you will have to practice sadhan bhakti. Sadhan bhakti means your bhakti. Bhakti can be seen. Bhakti cannot be seen. But the symptom of bhakti can be seen. Sadhan bhakti, how you know? When you are going to follow your Gurudev, you are doing all activities. Through your activities, through your sense organ, all your sense organ, going to do something, through sense organ, you are applying. Follow. You can get some application. So this way, sadhana vidha bhakti, this way you can go on practicing and ultimately you can come out successful. So, chinmay, everything. When you can find your mind is chinmay, when you can understand that your mind is chinmay. Chinmay means siddha avastha. Siddha avastha, it means that your mind is totally full of transcendental thoughts. Follow. Dhamma, Nama, all about Seva, Guru Vaishnava. You can see nothing material. You can search your mind, you can find nothing material left in your life. In that case, 100% sure that you are elevated to Siddha avastha. Follow. This is called Siddha Avastha. In Siddha Avastha, material, pain and pleasure, you know, respect and dishonor cannot touch you. Be careful. I am speaking neutrally about all the symptoms of a pure devotees. They are not going to play their head about who is going to respect me, who is going to insult me. That's not a big factor. They have no desire to take revenge. Follow. They have no desire to take revenge against somebody. I can see, what a man you are like. I will see what a man you are like. This is actually called, that actually this mood is not good. This is called actually, you have some desire to take revenge against somebody. This kind of mood never possible. With a prior, I already told yesterday, when Ramanujacharya was given poison with prasadam, with charanamrita, there was poison. Kures was attacked heavily, but still Ramanujacharya never wanted to express any angry attitude. He think all done directly or indirectly, it is one kind of testing going on in my life. So, they all Guru Vaishnav, they never express any kind of this kind of negative mood. Negative mood is very dangerous. Negative mood means you are in material condition. Negative mood means you cannot come out successful. Maybe you have some extraordinary power. Maybe you have some extraordinary power to catch people, hypnotize people. Those who are magicians, they have their hypnotizing power. Sure, they can show you, hey, I'm cutting that lady. Yes, it's cutting, but actually not cutting. This way we have seen those who are magicians, they can also. Practically in the world, practically, those who are fallen soul, already down, all in newspaper came through. Of course, there is also some cases in which some negative preaching going on, purposely, to put down somebody. Follow? Actually not see. So this way we have seen, they have some power, they develop. They have some power, it's a yogic power or some, black magic. Practically, you can go to Vrindavan. Guru fall down 5 years already, totally caught red-handed, but still his disciple, they are saying, is not very nice, Gurudev. How? But they have some hypnotizing power, they are catching. Some people can have their power to catch people, to motivate people. That is totally different from Sadguru's mood. The mood of Sadguru is totally different. He is going to do seva himself, gradually. His total heart is full of Krishna Bhakti. All the time, every fraction of second, non-stop he is going to satisfy Krishna some or other way. That's why somebody put a question in front of Prabhupada. Prabhupada, who is Vaishnava? How we can understand? Prabhupada told, he who is always, all the time, non-stop, always try to do something for Supreme Lord or Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, Dham, Nam. Always their mind is not, ideally sitting. Always try to do something for Dham, Nam, Parikar, Paisita. All the time engaged. He is Vaishnava. If I give some space to criticize somebody, if I give some space to attack somebody with some pre-planned, procedure, that is not the symptom of a pure Vaishnava. So, actually point is that in the life of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all we have seen, so many problems happened, but even Madhvacharya, who is so powerful, still with Madhvacharya so many problems happened. But still, Madhvacharya never wanted to take any revenge. On the contrary, I would like to project some special case, like Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur was beaten at 22 different markets, heavily, with whip. If one market they beat you, you can die. But in 22 different market, Haridas Thakur was beaten, but still Haridas Thakur simply praying that Prabhu, they please arrange some good for them, please. Please, they don't know what they are doing, please. So, this way, Vaishnavaru Avedane Krishna Dayamai Ehana Pamarpati Haiven Shavai. We always remember this point. Without the kippa of Guru Vaishnava, we cannot go even one fraction of second. Every moment, it is the Siddhanta of Prabhupada, every fraction of second we will have to cry for the mercy of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. That is the secrecy of Gauriya Bhajan. What is the secrecy of Gauriya Bhajan? Each and every fraction of second you will have to cry. You have to realize your weakness. Each and every fraction of second you will have to cry. You will have to realize your weakness. Prabhu, I cannot go. I cannot go. Please you help me. This is the procedure of Gauriya Bhajan. Those who are going to teach you different kind of bhajan, I am not going to take any responsibility about that. But there is massive preaching going on, what preaching, where going on, negative or positive. That is their responsibility. I have no time to judge. Life is very limited. So you see, though Haridas Thakur was beaten at 22 different markets, still Haridas Thakur praying, Prabhu, you arrange good for. They don't know what they are doing. You see, come on. They are growing their hostility with Haridas Thakur. Already they are getting order from their top boss to kill Haridas. But still Haridas Thakur expressing. Why? What can be the reason? Because Haridas Thakur having full of bhakti. Why? Bhakti naturally means, I can give so many examples, so you cannot misunderstand me. So many examples I can give. One by one, you can understand the mood of Vaishnava. So you see, they are actually Haridas Thakur praying cravingly. Oh Prabhu, please excuse them. No, they don't know what they are doing. Prahlad Maharaj yesterday, I already told. Prahlad Maharaj praying for those demoni, for those asura vayas in front of Nrisimhadev. This you see. Then also we can remember the case of that that king, Prahlad Maharaj and other, Draupadi, you see. Draupadi was kidnapped by whom? That, Draupadi was kidnapped by Dushala, husband of Dushala. Husband of Dushala. Nana, whose head was cut and fall into the hand of? Yes. His name. I forget the name. Yeah, you hope. He kidnapped Draupadi forcefully. After that, finally, Naraji Maharaj informing Jayadrata. Foolish. Jayadrata. So, Jayadrata wanted to kidnap forcefully. Draupadi was crying, nobody was there. So ultimately, Naraji Maharaj playing a very nice role. Now you are giving info, hey, your wife is being kidnapped by who? That Jayadrata. Oh, really? Bhim and Arjun running. Bhim like wind with club and Arjun in. Arjun make fire in front so that he cannot run anymore. Arjun is one arrow make fire in front of jungle so that he cannot move anymore. Stop up. Then Bhim going and catching him, Arjun, and like dog catch and pull all throughout the road up to the lotus feet of Yudhishthir Maharaj. Yudhishthir Maharaj, what we can do for this idiot? Yudhishthir Maharaj speaking. Actually, Yudhishthir Maharaj is very cool brain, very, very intelligent. If you like to understand what is the mood of Yudhishthir Maharaj, then you can go up in your life. Yudhishthir Maharaj, in front of Yudhishthir Maharaj, the question was put here, that they are putting the Bhima and Arjun, what punishment should be given to him? Oh, king. Then Yudhishthira, cool brain, thinking, Actually, this kind of misbehavior done with Draupadi. Let us hear what Draupadi want to say. Let us hear what Draupadi want to say. Then Yudhishthira asking, Draupadi, what do you propose? What kind of punishment we can give? That was speaking, Prabhu, you can make him free. Free? Why? Because if you are going to kill him, then your sister Dushala going to widow. So we cannot do that way. So you have to let him free. Free? Yes. After that, they shave one side of hair, one side of beard, and throw. This way, you can remember, this Jayadrata one case, and about the son of Ashwatthama, also same case. Ashwatthama, of course, that was Uttariya, Uttara, and Draupadi also wanted to, because that time, Brahmastra was, you know, there. That song, that time also, he was brought, tied hand, chained. Yes. That time also, Draupadi is speaking, if you are going to kill him, then your Gurudev, your Guruma, going to lose his son. And your Gurudev, from whom you are going to learn everything, bow and arrow, all mystery of, you know, so you should not kill him. This way, all the time we find this kind of soft heart of Vaishnava. Because Vaishnava always merciful. You can remember, maybe 1 or 2 months before I was speaking one sloka. I can remember, you forget. What day, why, Anna? I was speaking this thing. That time I was speaking, that kokil anam saro rupam. What is the beauty of kokil? What is the excellency of kokil? Is his tone, voice. Koo, this voice. Kokil. So kokil anam saro rupam. His kantha saw the voice is itself excellency. Kokil anam saro rupam. Narinam patibratam. For woman, their submission under the lotus feet of husband, proper husband, actual husband, you will have to, is there actually, not external beauty, not that. So, kokilanam saro rupam, narinam pratibratam, vidya rupam kurupanam. Those who are very ugly to look, for them, their education and qualification. Their, you know, vidya, education is power, their beauty. But, pashadu, those who are really sadhu, khama rupam tapasinam, those who are sadhu, 100 per day always, if you are going to kill, excuse me, okay, go. This kind of humble mood, this kind of soft mood we can find at the heart of Guru Vaishnava. If I give 1 or 2 examples, you can understand. Maybe you can remember 2-3 years back, I told 100% that when Siddhanta Goswami Maharaj, who published, you know, Vedanta and Upanishad there in Hajra, that day I was speaking about him. Because he thinks, Prabhupada is my Diksha Guru and Shikha Guru is Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj. That day I was speaking about it. Perhaps you can remember. That time, Siddhanta Maharaj, when Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj gone, he was made acharya, full acharya of all moth, everything given to him. He is very strict. After that, he is giving warning to 2 sannyasis. You should not go to the house of grihastha. Especially husband gone. Husband gone means husband gone to some place, or another case, husband die. So you have no right to go there. You cannot go. But they are not going to obey. You are sannyasi. After giving instruction repeatedly, they are not going to obey. Ultimately, Srila Siddhanta Maharaj catch their, you know, apron, you know, sannyas vest and tear. Give me my danda and everything. I can go away from here. Throw them out. So heavy. At present, they have no, that kind of heart is not there. Their heart is very weak. At present, we cannot find that kind of acharya like Santa Goswami Maharaj, beating sannyasi with chapal. Chapal, you know? Karam, wooden chapal. Wooden chapal, beating. Heavily. Kesab Goswami Maharaj, hey, go. You have to fast for 3 days. Fasting 3 days. You have to wash your mouth with, you know, cow dung and urine and gangajal. What? This kind of acharya at present we cannot find. So heavy. Prabhupad is rare acharya. Rare. We cannot find such. So actually, Prabhupad also many times going to excuse. Okay. That time, they wanted to take revenge. They wanted to take revenge again, Maharaj, Siddhanta Maharaj. When night time, that was winter season, Maharaj sleeping with Maharaj not, you know, closing door, nothing. They are sleeping and with kambal. Then they come with a cutter, they wanted to cut the throat of Siddhanta Maharaj. They be the full force. By the magic spell of Nityananda, that day especially, Maharaj keep his head that side. Every day Maharaj putting head that side, I don't know. That day especially putting his head that side, wrong side. Then his, oh, kambal was there, but still his leg cutting, blood coming, force. All there was, you know, shouting. Then the devotee could realize who is the culprit. Devotees, they could realize who is the culprit. Then case, they file one case. After that case going on, ultimately Siddhanta Maharaj was called in court. He was bound to go in court, standing in the place where, you know, you have to stand. And, you know, the victim, you know, and I mean the, you know, that criminal, you know, standing there. And those, you know, pleaders, they are exchanging their, you know, word. After that, finally, actually, that pleader speaking, look, Maharaj, he is that culprit? You look, he is that culprit? You know him? He was caught? Maharaj looking at his eyes, very mercifully, for a long time. After that speaking, not. What do you say? What do you say? He is that criminal who wanted to kill you, attempt to murder. Maharaj said, no. Somebody else. He was set free. That day we could realize that Siddhanta Maharaj is so tough, so tough, so tough, but still so merciful. Externally you can find a Vaishnava is too heavy. Externally you can find a Vaishnava is too merciless, heavy. But be sure that he is more and more merciful than any other idealism maybe you have in your life. You can think he is most merciful. He is more and more merciful. You cannot understand the heart of a Vaishnava. If you go to pass any kind of remark about Guru Vaishnava, it's a great offense. Don't try to do. So this kind of example I can go on speaking one by one to prove that Guru Vaishnava is most merciful incarnation. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Vaishnava charitro sabai sadai pavitro. In Bengali, you can go through this kirtan. It is my request. Vaishnava charitro sadai pavitro. Je ninde hingsha kori. Out of the jealousy, he was going to pass some remark, going to criticize. Bhakti vinod na sambhashitare. Bhakti vinod Thakur don't want to talk with him. Thake sada mauna dhori. Follow what I say. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Vaishnava charitro sadai pavitro je ninde hingsha kori, bhakati vinod na sambhase tare sada thake mauna dhori. Keep silence, don't talk with him. So, total non-cooperation we should do. Those who are Vaishnava aparadhi, it is my request, If you at all want to take bhakti, those who are Vaishnava aparadhi, you cannot insult him. But it is the rule that you will have to pass him away. Guru Vaishnav can pass heavy remark, they can chide, because they have their power. When Gurudev, Vaishnav going to speak something heavy against somebody, they are not going to get any feedback result. Not that. Follow? Because this is the duty of Guru Vaishnav. They are in neutral form, they have no jealousy. They cannot speak anything against anybody against anybody. They cannot speak. But they still they are speaking. Why? To give you a caution. Follow? So that we can become careful. This is the system. That is why bhakti, you can remember, many times I told before, Tulsidas ji speaking, Sadguru mile bhed batave. Sadguru mile bhed batave, gyan kare upadesh, kaila ka maila chute, jab aak kare pravesh. Sadguru, it is the duty of Sadguru, because you are now acting as Sadguru. It is your duty to guide people properly. This is wrong, this Siddhanta is bad, this... Hey, why you are going that way? Come! You think it's merciless. Not that. Not that. But they are giving you indication, if you go that way, you can lose your bhakti. But unnecessarily, Guru Vaishnava never misguide. I can give one example from the topmost teacher in the whole infinity universe. His name is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I can give one example. You can remember one day, Brahmananda Bharati coming with tiger skin. And Mahaprabhu was given information by Mukunda and so devotees that Brahmananda Bharati coming. Can we bring him to you? No, no, no. He is our Guru Varga. I must go to him. He is our Guru Varga. You are going to... No, no. I can go to him. Mahaprabhu going very quickly to him. In front of Brahmananda Bharati, he already reaching. And thinking, where is Brahmananda Bharati? Here you are. Ha! Foolish. This cannot be so. Who is Brahmananda Bharati? It's not Brahmananda Bharati. How is possible that Brahmananda Bharati going to wear tiger skin? Thu! Foolish. Annore anno kaho nahi tomar gyan. You have no common sense. You are speaking this Brahmananda Bharati. Why Brahmananda Bharati can wear? You see the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then Brahmananda Bharati could readily catch the point. Oh, he don't like that I wear tiger skin. Okay, okay. Then readily going and changing clothes and coming in. Ha, is Brahmananda Bharati. Follow? But mind it, what is the actual siksha? Actually, Mahaprabhu wanted to give respect to his Guru Varga. Mahaprabhu wanted to give respect to Guru Varga, na? Brahmananda Bharati Guru Varga. But still, Mahaprabhu couldn't accept this point done by him. Follow? This point, Mahaprabhu came, because he is, you know, total capacity there, Supreme Lord, he can do it. So this way, Mahaprabhu going to show us, if at all any wrong activities, they should not do it. Brahma is our Adi Guru, okay? Externally, we find Brahma is doing some wrong. Brahma running behind his daughter, Saraswati. If somebody laughing, it's dangerous. Maybe it is the arrangement of Krishna to show us Mama Maya Duratvaya. Maybe. Guru cannot do mistake. But those who are not Guru, they can make mistake. Each and every fraction of second. Now I can give another example. How to become humble. How to become humble. You can remember when that Digvijay Pandit, you know, coming in Navadip, that time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, only a school boy, small boy. I mean, boy man growing up, giving, you know, giving teachings about Vyakaran, learning something, student lila. That time Mahaprabhu was sitting in at the bank of Ganga, na? That time Ganga flowing very nice, breezy, and prismin. With the water particles of Ganga, air flowing, it's a breezy. That time actually very nice weather, full moon there, under trees, Mahaprabhu sitting. That time Digvijaya Pandit coming in front of him. And when Digvijaya Pandit coming, he is going to speak something very with negligency. Oh, I heard you. Oh, your name is Nimaya. I heard your name because you are going to give lesson about Ballo Bhakaran. Bhakaran to small small boys, you are going to give teachings. Huh? I heard your name. With negligency speaking. Yes. Actually, I cannot give proper lesson because I myself don't know Vyakaran properly. Oh, really? I heard that you are big Pandit. Ah, actually. So, we like you are here. We are lucky that you are here. We like to hear something about the glories of Ganga. Could you please? Then, Mahattam Gangayam Satatam Idam Avati this slok. Started speaking like wind. Not one slow, like long, you cannot write, long. After the month, very fantastic. But could you please speak, there is some, one sloka, Mahaprabhu speaking. This sloka is very nice. Could you please indicate some defects there, mistake there? What do you mean? You are only a small boy. How you can understand the glories of my writing? Really so. I cannot understand, but I heard something from senior devotee, senior teachers. I am not going to read chanda and everything, anupras. I'm not, but I heard something. So I think if you can with cool pen, if you can indicate, then we can learn something. He is going to show a puffed up mood. Huh? You read anything about it? Oh, no, I don't read. Then why you are speaking? Then Mahaprabhu started speaking. Here, four defects are there. Four defects are there. Pandit gone mad. How possible a small boy going to indicate? Huh? Indicate such mistake in my writing. Oh my God. He was just stunned. Cannot speak anything. Speechless. Then everybody started laughing. Hey! Why you are laughing? Don't laugh. Stop. Maybe today you are sick or maybe you are feeling uneasy. You can go to home and have a look in Shastra. Tomorrow you can come. We can meet again. Mahaprabhu never going to insult that Digvijaya Pandit. Whereas it is the rule, usual rule, everywhere you look in whole over the world, anywhere two Pandit argument, the mood of one Pandit is to defeat other and, even the case of, Baladev Vidyabhushan started fighting with, what is her name, I forget, in Samananda Pariva. But he never wanted to insult anybody. But finally he was defeated, and the condition was that if you are defeated, then you will have to take diksha from me. If I am defeated, I will have to take diksha. Then Baba Vidyasan took the. So usually you see the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu all the time. Even you can remember those who are going to attack Mahaprabhu, Bhattathari, because they almost going to kidnap. It is one kind of kidnap. They saw that you can come and enjoy Kalakrishna Das gone there. Whereas Mahaprabhu running there to deliver Kalakrishna Das. They wanted to beat with the cutter, cutter. Then all their cutter falling on their head. They cut their hand and leg, their blood coming out, they are shouting. You can remember another case, one by one speaking. When Buddhist, they are Pasandi. This Buddhist leader, they wanted to give some poison as a very useless, very, very impure, apavitro, prasad. Then automatically Mahaprabhu, prasadam. Then that vulture came and took the plate up and throw the plate, falling on head and cut the head of their leader, they're crying. This way, Mahaprabhu, each and every time, showing us the mood, how to deliver common soul, bonded soul. If you are going to deliver, if you want to deliver common soul, then we have to follow some special technique. Follow Kushti Vipri, Kushti Vipro, you can remember. When Kushti Vipro was delivered, Mahaprabhu embraced him and giving him order. You can go to home and today onward, Maya not going to put you in trouble. Mahaprabhu speaking, giving. Mahaprabhu giving, blessing him and speaking, from today onward, Maya not going to give you, put you in trouble. You go, Puno, repeatedly will have to speak Krishna Nam and go and you try to deliver all common souls there in your adjacent area. Follow? Amar aggay guru hoya taro ei desh. Vasudev Vipro. Follow? Then, you know, what is them? Vasudev, Kushti Vipro, you know, Kurma Vipro, na? I forget. Okay. So, that time he was delivered and giving order, go and... So, this way Mahaprabhu translates some power in him. If he is going to follow Mahaprabhu from heart, then he can keep intact that power. If in the beginning of spiritual life, I show some inclination, after that if I am deviated from the track of Guru Padpadma, want to prove something else, in that case, surely I cannot come out successful. Big problem in that case. So, one by one, you can see the case, how the heart of Vaishnava is always soft. They can never take revenge against anybody. I was speaking this slok that Kama Rupam Tapasinam, those who are devotee, those who are bhakta, tapasya, astuti and penances is practically applicable for Guru Vaishnava. Why I mean this way? Because somebody can mean with other, those who are doing astuti, I am not. Because I am not going to apply this case in, apply this point in case of Hiranyakasipu. He is also doing astuti and penances. Follow. About whom it is written, na bhutam na bhavishvati. Never in past, done, not in future. Nobody. But still I am not going to apply. Because his astuti and finances is not to satisfy Supreme Lord. To get some extraordinary power. To put whole world into trouble. This much. So, creative activity is totally different. Yesterday I told you already. So, this way, I can show you that the mood of a Vaishnava, also you can remember Sarvam Vattacharya, Vairagya Vidya Nija Bhakti Yoga. Vairagya means detachment. But that detachment is not dry detachment. That detachment is not dry detachment. When your heart is full of bhakti, automatically detachment can grow. Grow or not? Automate. It's an automatic fact. You need not show people that I have detachment. It's an automatic factor. So you have to learn that I can discuss anasakta svisayana vi. Yatharham Vayanjato Athava or Prapanchikataya Vidya Harishamandi Vasna, this true slok. Mahaprabhu or Prabhupada giving repeated reminder. If you forget these two slok, you can become demon. If you forget these two slok, you can become demon. You can attack other Guru Vaishnava. Be careful. Don't try to forget. I can show the diagram. I am going to translate very quickly. All those writings so that people can get, those who are interested, those who are not interested, they can follow. They cannot follow. Okay, no problem. So here you see, Vairagya is Vidya in the case of pure Guru Vaishnava. Vairagya is one kind of Vidya, not Avidya. Avidya means ignorance. Vidya and Avidya, two things there. Vidya means knowledge and ignorant. Avidya. So, Avidya cannot touch a pure Guru Vaishnava. So, I cannot indicate this sloka for Hiranyakasipu. So, when I say that Vidya, you know, Vidya Rupam Kurupanam, those who are ugly looking for them, Vidya is the very nice appearance. Vidyarupam Gurupanam and Khamarupam Tapasinam. Repeatedly, 100 of times, Krishna, 108 times, going to excuse Sushupal. Krishna promised in front of, you know, paternal uncle, I can excuse him 108 times. After that, you see the mood of Krishna, repeatedly in front of everybody, insulting Krishna heavily, all abusing Krishna, speaking all rubbish. Still Krishna is not excited. When 108 offenses complete, then Krishna going to open the wheel and throw. Also, I can give the reminder that when you are going to lose your patience, that means you are not Vaishnava. When you are going to lose your patience, that means you are not Vaishnava, perfect Vaishnava. At any how, we cannot lose our patience. So I can repeatedly on next coming days, I can go on discussing what is the direct request to all devotees, especially those who are preaching ground. Directly, I can show you what Prabhupada is speaking. So you see, from there, you see, if you're going to lose, patience, then in that case, big problem happen. Because the basic thing of preaching, all the basic thing of preaching, what is the vital point? Before going from preaching, maybe you have some extraordinary power, but that is not the quality of preaching. Brikho jano katilo kishuna boloi sukaiya moile kare panina mangoi jeya mangoi tare gai upon dhon gharmo vishti swahe aner kore rakshan. This is the symptom Bhaktivinoda speaking. A tree not going to express any agitation against anybody, whereas he is going to cut the tree itself. I was sitting under the sea, under my shade, you are getting, you're sitting here under my shade. I know, but still you are a shadow. You are going to cut me. You are taking fruits and flower daily, leaves, everything, and you are going to cut me. Why? What wrong I have done? No. Our Guru Vaishnava cannot have any complaint. That is why Prabhupada used to say, tomorrow I can discuss. What is the symptom of a pure Vaishnava? They cannot have any complaint. Pure Vaishnaver kono din Vishuddha Vaishnaver kono abhiyog thake na against anybody. There is a symptom of pure Vaishnava. In whole life, nobody was successful to agitate Bhakti Vita Madhav Goswami Maharaj, Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj. Nobody successful. They failure. So this way we know Brikho jano kati leo kichuna volai sukaila, nobody going to give water to me. I am fasting, no water there. Still, trees not going to beg anything. Brikho jano kati leo kichuna volai sukaiya mohile kane parina mangai. Whatever thing they are going to ask, they are going to. Aho esham varam janmo. Krishna speaking. Aho esham varam janmo. You see, those trees and creepers, they are very, very nice. They only took the resolution to serve and serve and serve and serve, not to take anything in return. Losing patience means to get lost. Losing patience means you are totally deviated from the lotus feet of Guru Padma. Losing patience means you are totally deviated from the lotus feet of Guru Padma. So long you are resting on the lotus feet of Guru Padma, then you cannot feel too hot, too cold, thirsty, hungry, kama. No. Because all balanced. Because you are. I can give you one example. When one big Atlantic Ocean, Pacific Ocean, you are going to add 1,000 gallons of water. Follow? You are going to add 1,000 gallons of water in the ocean of Pacific and Titan. How much I am contribution, my how is increasing or decreasing, or take out thousands of gallons of water from sea? No change. Follow the mood of, this is the mood of Guru Vaishnava. Because they are always in touch with Anantadev. Try to understand this point. Why they are not going to feel any dissatisfaction? What can be the reason? Why they are not going to feel any dissatisfaction in their life? Why? Simply because they are in connection with Anantadev, infinity. Anantadev is there sitting, so how they can feel dissatisfied? How they can feel kama, krodha, hostile attitude, you know? No, it's not possible. This is the mood of pure Guru Vaishnava. You will have to understand very, very carefully, then you can understand. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking this way, and among all Paramahansa, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, we are very lucky to get Gaurakishore. Because though Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj is topmost Paramahansa, though Sukhdev Goswami is topmost Paramahansa, still Sukhdev Goswami is speaking all rubbish against all bonded soul. Sha, khara, varaha, osto, sangstuta, purushaha. Who is speaking? Paramahansa Sesto. He is not going to beg for anything, not even drinking water or milk, nothing. Prasadam means only milk he is going to take, but nothing. That also sometime. That Sukhdev Goswami is Paramahansa Sesto going to speak all rubbish. Against? Sha, varaha, khara, osto, sangstuta, purushaha. Yeah, all, you know, they're ass. They're ass. Badaho, they're actually, you know, badaho, boar, badaho, pig, follow. This way giving heavy. Kharo, gardab, crossbeat of horse and ass. It's called khachar. Usually, this kind of animal you can find in Himalayan place. Because they are very patience there. If there is no word, they cannot feel happy. They cannot feel happy. If you give too much word, then they feel happy there. Then I can go very, now you are very good. So we are actually this kind of animal. Follow. If burden is there, then good. If there is no burden, so, Paramahansa Sesto, Sukhdev Goswami Maharaj, speaking so heavily. Do you think Sukhdev Goswami is very angry? That's why speaking? You think so? Not at all. It's one kind of kripa. Do you think that Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj is very angry with them? Not at all. But still we are very lucky that Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj is speaking so many things. Or other Paramahansa is really not speaking anything. Keep silence and go on doing bhajan. This way, you see, Sukhdev Goswami is saying his mode. This way, gradually we find, so Rontidev also, what kind of patience? Rontidev, what kind of patience is there? Oh! But still, Rontidev praying to Supreme Lord Prabhu. You give all their, you know, all their, you know, what kind of punishment you are supposed to give them? Give to me. I can bear everything. But please. You can remember the case when Haridas Thakur was insulted by one Gopal that is there in Saptagram at the village of Raghunath Das Goswami, Hiranyagar Govardhan. Their house. You can remember? Uddharan Datta was there. They wanted to insult. Haridas Thakur simply speaking Harikatha. Not going to insult anybody. Speaking the glories of Harinam. But that Brahman, young man, is so puffed up, he stand up, you are actually foolish, foolish. You are speaking, astuti and finances cannot do this thing, only Harinam can do. Haridasa said, folded, why you cannot believe? This kind of power is there in Harinam. Oh, foolish actually. You are actually, Bachal. Bachal, you know, who is speaking rubbish. It's called Bachal. Unnecessary talkings. Oh, speaking all rubbish to Haridas Thakur. Everybody crying. Hiranyakashipu is, you foolish? You are insulting Namacharya Haridas Thakur? Then they leave you. Go away from us. That man was so puffed up speaking, if Nam going to not going to give this, then you will have to cut your nose. Otherwise, I can cut my nose and prove. Haridas Thakur, why you become so angry? This kind of quality is there in Harinam. All power there in Harinam. Harinamani asti tavati shakti papo nirharane harehe. Harehe. Hare. Mane harir hari charane papo nirharane. A Harinam having so power that papi, sin, that sinful man cannot do that kind of many sinful activities. What is not, you know, what cannot be erased by Harinam. That kind of power. But Haridas Thakur is not angry. When that man is gone, everybody is saying, hi, hi, oh my God, oh my God, oh Prabhu, we are watching this kind of insultment of one big Vaishnava. Oh my God. After that, within one day, 24 hours, that, you know, that Gopal, his name is also, not Chapal Gopal, his name is also Gopal, Gopal Chakravarti. His nose is very nice, sharp nose. Now develop Kushto, leprosy, and boiling down this way, all melted, everybody crying. Right punishment getting. Really so. In our Shastra, I can show you one by one. If you are going to do dangerous aparadh, you can develop Kushto, leprosy, or different kind of disease, TB. In Shastra, it is written. If you are doing all different wrong activities, wrong aparadh, then this blood circulation become very disturbed. Blood itself become from mind and blood physical connection is there. Then from mind translated to body, body become toxic. It can develop leprosy. All melted, hand and leg, everything. Oh my God. This way. Everybody going to repent. Oh, Haridas. Haridas Thakur with very calm and quiet speaking. Why you become angry? Eh? Why you become excited? Huh? Why is, what kind of, you know? Actually, still then, Haridas Thakur speaking, tar kono dosh nai, tar tarkonishtha mon. If you understand, go and read this. What is the meaning? Haridas Thakur still then speaking, tar kono dosh nai, tar tarkonishtha mon. Why you are going to blame him? His mind is itself logical, you know, interpretation going on. Always there, inside his mind. So why are you need not, you should not blame him. This is a symptom of Guru Vaishnava, you see. This way we find that it is quite impossible that a Vaishnava become agitated, Vaishnava can take revenge against somebody, speak something against somebody, quite impossible. You cannot prove. You cannot prove. Anytime you cannot prove. You have no evidence in the history of Vaishnavism, there is no such evidence. If there is a mentality to take revenge against somebody, against whom? Because you are going to, if you are not going to look this whole world in respect of Krishna, follow my point, Mataji. If you are not established in Advaigyan Tattva, then you are not Vaishnav. Advaigyan Tattva, there is one single Tattva. Where you find somebody insulting me? Why you find somebody going to snatch something from me? But Advaigan Tattva. You have to relate whole infinity universe with Krishna. It is the arrangement of Krishna. Tattva nukampa susamiksha manam bunjana eva atmakrita vipakam. Why not you think this? It is my activity maybe. When Dhruva Maharaj was insulted by his stepmother, you can remember, I like to remind her so many things so that you cannot misunderstand me. This is my request. Then Dhruva was insulted. Dhruva bursted into tears, going to mother and speaking. Mother, what happens, my boy? Insulting me this way, not allow me to climb the lap of my father. What happens this way? Dhruva described everything. Then mother started speaking. Actually, you should not repent. I am so unlucky lady. I am so unlucky lady. My luck is very bad. That's why Kim going to leave me in a solitary place, not going to accept me. Maybe my luck is bad. Maybe I have done some mistake. And you are also unlucky because you have taken birth in my womb. Dhruva, you should not cry. My son, always you will have to think what you are getting result. That is the what you are going to get punishment, that is a result of my past activities. You should not blame anybody. Follow. Dhruva's mother speaking. Dhruva, my son, any kind of punishment, any kind of insultment you are going to receive, you should think, actually, according to his past activities. Why you are going to blame somebody? You should not blame. Man going to get their own activity. Okay. Then Dhruva Maharaj getting advice from mother, total, complete solution is Krishna Bhakti, Vishnu Bhakti. Follow? Total solution what? Vishnu Bhakti. Okay. Only indication taken from mother. He got indication from. Paddha Phala Solution Narayana Harihi can solve all problems. The only solution is resting there unto the lotus feet of Sadguru and Ballaji Maharaj and Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Nityananda Advaita Gosai. You cannot find any solution of any fighting anywhere. You cannot find any solution. That's why Dhruva Maharaj started doing bhajan. Follow? So by then, when Dhruva Maharaj was successful, started thinking, if at all my stepmother not going to insult me, I am not feeling very heavy, I am not crying, I am not approaching my mother with crying mood, then mother would not have given me this kind of advice and I would not have gone to forest to study. Oh, that's why yesterday I told you, you can remember that those who are Guru Vaishnav, they are positive thinking. Though they are speaking heavily, but they themselves, they are positive thinking. They are speaking to rectify the condition, not with envious attitude. Follow? So they, to think everything positive, to think everything positive way is called vaikuntha darshan. To think everything positive, somebody insulting you, but you will have to think it's positive way. So this, if you can look everything positive way, that is called vaikuntha darshan. Follow? What is the excellency? So now, Dhruva Maharaj, due to this incident, now Dhruva Maharaj is going to do bhajan, and now successful in bhajan, and Hari coming to him to see my small boy. Everywhere, just opposite, you are doing bhajan, and Krishna or Vishnu going to give you darshan. Give you darshan. But in this case, totally opposite. Every time what happens? When you do bhajan, Krishna, Vishnu or Nityananda coming in dream or somehow. What is the symptom? That a devotee already enjoying full keep of Nityananda in dream or some way, then you can see some fire coming. It's a symptom. By symptom you will have to understand. Simply by his not out of their his proficiency is not speaking. As if somebody backing to speak this, to rectify the situation. If you go against him, a total devastation. Total. You can try and go against Haridas, go against Prabhupada, go against somebody. You can go and show me. Totally material condition can create. You can create total material, spiritual condition, total vanish. Only material, business. Nothing can be left in your life. Be careful. What is more punishment than this thing? That Nityananda going to put in material ocean with material appliances for infinity period. What can be more dangerous punishment than that? Is the extreme punishment. Better Krishna can beat me, cut me. Okay, stay, next life Krishna can give. But not. Life after life, infinity period. Go, stay. I cannot excuse you because you have done offense at the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. So, this way you see, Guru Vaishnava actually tatya nukampam. Dhruva Maharaj going to see Krishna, I mean Prabhu Madhusudan in front of Hari. Paddap, paddo, palasalochana, Hari, coming in front of you. In that case, Hari speaking, it is written in Bhagavatam, that Hari not going to keep him darshan, but Hari speaking, I am interested to see my small devotee. It is written in Bhagavatam, I like to see, I am very much interested, see my small devotee. Dekhte eschilen, to see, not to show, see. So this kind of. So this way you see, Brahma, our Adi Guru wanted to teach us, Tathya Anukampam Susamiksha Manam. In your life, if you are going to face any kind of trouble, unusual events, anything happened. In my life, so many things happened. All they cheat me, take everything away, make me beggar. Nothing they are going, everything taken. Library, all taken by, nothing left. I was bound to go to forest almost. Nothing there. They thought maybe today or tomorrow he can die. So cold there, no kambal, nothing there. You cannot remember. If I put you into that situation, you can die. Who protect me? Who protect me? Gurudev. With a simple one sack of potato and ground. Ground mean? Not cement ground. Only mud ground. And I arrange only two kambal. Nothing. Very light. I put. And months after month, not sleeping. Only this is. I couldn't sleep. That is very good. It is one kind of blessing in my life. If that kind of enduring power is not developed in my life, then I would have died by this time. They all wanted to develop disease in my life, these, that, so kill him. Why? Why Jagai Madai want to break the head of Nityananda? Simply because Nityananda Prabhu wanted to seek their good. That is the reason, na? Why Jagai Madai wanted to break the head of Nityananda? In front of Nityananda, all demonic people can get melted. But they are going to beat. Blood coming out. Why they wanted to beat Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada? Why? Simply because Prabhupada wanted to show their exact track. That's why, na? They wanted to attack. Why that two demonic character people wanted to attack Siddhanti Maharaj? Because Siddhanti Maharaj wanted to seek their highest good. Whenever, why they want to attack me, stop my Harikatha? What can be the reason? Only one reason. In Vyasasana I am sitting, I have no enmity, I don't like to pick up any enmity. Only the thing, I like to show that this is the point. This way you have to run. He is speaking lie. Maybe he is Guru Bhargava. He is speaking lie. All Guru Bhargava are not going to get same respect. All Guru Bhargava are not Prabhupada Parshad. Many people going to fight with me. They are all Parshad of Prabhupada. No, they are not Parshad. Why? Why you say? Then Prabhupada coming here in this material world, simply coming and going. Huh? It is written that Prabhupada coming and taking sannyas base, why? To deliver others. You can remember. I can remind you the case of Ramchandrapuri. Ramchandrapuri is always interested to criticize devotees. Huh? Why? But say he is a disciple of Madhavendra Puri Bhad. Hey, Maharaj is Guru. I know. So what? I know. So what? So what? He is a disciple of Madhavendra. That doesn't mean he is going to get same power of Madhavendra Puri. Whereas Ishwar Puri Bhad not going to find fault with any devotees. He is blessed by Gurudev. Total blessing. Due to excellent Guru Seva, even Supreme Lord Paratvara Khileshwar Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was bound to accept him as Guru, to give him the honor of Guru. Why? Because he is getting excellency regarding Guru Seva. Madhavendra Viva passing tools and urine, stool and urine, he cleaning, but not thinking, dirty stool and urine. Follow. In my life, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, I am getting this kind of seva. One Vaishnava going to leave body. I saw him, like mad, lying. Urine, stool. He cannot pass. You know, by the mercy of. But never I want, by the mercy of Gurudev and Vaishnava, self-effulgent. Never developed, never wanted to develop any material. Material conception. Vaishnav or Prakita. Drishta Sabhava Janitai Bapuscha Dosa Ittadi. I can explain someday. So you see the case of Ramchandrapuri. He is always going to find fault with Guru Vaishnav. He is going to feel, hey, you are taking so much prasadam? You have any property? Hare Maharaj, you are giving me prasadam. It is written there. He is giving, you will have to take some chana rasa again. You have to do this way. And rice also, paramanna also, he is giving. After that, when prasadam, you know, finish, then see, you are taking so much prasadam, you have any property? Who am I? You are giving, and then again criticizing. Then, Vaishnava aparadh is such a thing, cannot make you free, life after life. Whatever be the condition, if Shankar Bhagavan is there, still not going to get any respite. Sulopani Shambhu jodi adhikari hoy, Vrindavan das Thakur bas. Sulopani Shambhu. Sulopani means Shankar. Many names of Shankar. Pinaki, Dhurjoti, Shankar, Bholenath, Mahadev. Shankar. So many names of. But anyway, if Shankar is going to make, be sure, not going to get any sign. Any excuse. So regarding Vaishnava aparadh, we should be very careful. So, Ramchandrapuri was going to criticize our Guru Vaishnava. So ultimately what happens? That Vaishnava aparadh ultimately going to give you a backing to find fault with Supreme Lord Himself. Ah, you must have taken sweet ball or paramanna. Why there is an ants moving all around? Mapo looking. Be careful. He is also Guru Varga. Be careful. Never mind. He is also Guru Varga. Mapo giving too much respect to him. Mapo not speaking anything. But surely you are so greedy. Mapo not speaking anything. After some day, next when he gone, calling Govinda, Govinda, from there, it is my prasadam rule, strict regulation. If you are going to follow my strict regulation, then I am going to stay here, otherwise I am going to leave this place. Ah, what Prabhupada? Actually, the prasad you are getting from me, one fourth of that prasad I can take, and the rest. Why, Prabhu, what happens? I don't like to answer. One fourth. Everybody crying. Oh, Prabhu, you are going to... No. Ramchandra Paripad, foolish number one, is speaking. Why? Why you are going to find fault with Ramchandra Puri? Yes, proper instruction given by him. Mahaprabhu speaking. When somebody is crying and speaking, giving, who is responsible for that? Ramchandra Prabhu say no. Why you are giving him, holding him responsible? He is not responsible. He is speaking what is right. A sannyasi, I am sannyasi, I should not run my life that way. It's right, properly. Good advice given by him. So till then, Mahaprabhu, not anxious, not going to find any fault with. But ultimately, he was totally fall down. You can remember the case of Amog, the son in law, Sarvam Vatajajo, know his mood. So not going to allow him to enter into room to see, watch what Jagannath Mahaprabhu going to take prasadam. But somehow he is very interested to watch what kind of prasadam, because my in-law, my father-in-law not going to give that kind of prasadam to me. Let me see. When serving, the window was open. Then through window he come secretly and, oh my God, the 20 people can eat this kind of rice is taking. Then Sarvam Vatajajo going to beat him with stick. Run, he fly. Sarvam Vatajajo started crying. Shati Ma, the wife of Sarvam Vatajajo, started crying. Oh, Prabhu, we call you to insult. Prabhu, we call you to insult. Prabhu, excuse us. Oh yeah, excuse us, please. Prabhu sir, Prabhu laughing. Why you are his child actually? Why you are going to, mind so much? After that, within some hours, that Amog developing cholera. Dangerous cholera. Going to die now and then. The condition of Amog is now and then. Anytime he can die. Mahaprabhu take prasadam very freshly, without any comment, and giving consolation to them. You take prasadam and go. But they are fasting. When Mahaprabhu take information, running and coming, and embracing Sarvamohan. Why, you small boy? Why you are going to, maybe yes. You have to take prasadam, please. Somehow, yes, okay, done. Then in front, let me go. Because the son-in-law, Sarvabhauma, going to die. Sati going to become widow. How Mahaprabhu can be here? So Mahaprabhu saying, I can go to Sarvabhauma. Where is he? He's going to die? Mahaprabhu go. Touching the heart of that Amok. He's doing all blunder, no? And speaking, Amok. Sahaja nirmal ei brahman hidoy. You are actually brahman. Your heart should be very pure. Krishner vasati ei yogyasthal hoy. Mahaprabhu speaking with very painful mood, touching the heart of Amog and speaking, Amog. Sahaja nirmal, naturally, the heart of a brahman is very pure because those are sudra. If they are going to climb the highest post of Acharya, still they cannot, they can never stop repenting. Because Shudra, what is the explanation of Shudra? Shokam karoti iti Shudraha. Who is always repenting? Somebody insulted me, someone said, Are, who insulted you? Who insulted you? Why you take that way? So, now Mahaprabhu speaking, touching the heart of, Amog, sahaja nirmal ei brahman hidaye, কৃষ্ণের বসতি এই যজ্ঞস্থল হয়। হ্যাঁ, কৃষ্ণের বসতি, কৃষ্ণ ক্যান সিট ইনসাইড ইউর হার্ট। ন্যাচুরালি ব্রাহ্মণ হার্ট ইজ ভেরি, হ্যাঁ, মাশ্চর্য চণ্ডাল ক্যানে ইহা বসাইলা, ওয়াই ইউ আর ইনভাইটিং মাশ্চর্য জেলাস এন ও চণ্ডাল টু সিট ইন ইউর হার্ট? পবিত্র স্থান কেন অপবিত্র কইলা? মাশ্চর্য চণ্ডাল ক্যানে ইহা বসাইলা, ওয়াই ইউ আর গোয়িং টু ইনভাইট মাশ্চর্য চণ্ডাল জেলাস লাইক ইউ নো চণ্ডাল টু সিট দে and make the place contaminated so that Krishna cannot come. Pavitra sthan, hello, what speaking actually? Mahaprabhu speaking. Sahaja nirmal ei brahman hidaye, sahaja nirmal ei brahman hidaye, Krishner basati ei yogya sthal hoy. Mashajya chandal kani iha basaila, pavitra sthan kena apavitra koila? This is the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We are going to follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So all Guru Varga, not all Siddha. I am not going to make any offense to Lotus Feet, any Guru Varga. With truth say I am speaking. I am speaking about their absolute truth. Otherwise why Prabhupada taking sannyas? পতিতোদ্ধরণে কৃত বেশযতিম, ওয়াই পতিতোদ্ধরণে কৃত বেশযতিম, দোজ আর পতিত ফলেন টু ডেলিভার দেম প্রভুপাদ হ্যাজ কাম। হোয়াট ডু ইউ মিন প্রভুপাদ কামিং অ্যান্ড গোয়িং? প্রভুপাদ নট গোয়িং টু ডেলিভার এনিবডি? অল গৃহস্থ ভক্ত, অল এভরিবডি, দোজ আর অল ইউ নো নিত্যসিদ্ধ? নো, নট দ্যাট, নট দ্যাট। The symptom, how we can understand? Secrecy. If you can see that Guru Varga going to implement the teachings of Prabhupada directly, intactly, without any addition or alteration, is actually, I can explain this point gradually, directly, with scientific evidence, I can prove. Those who are not going to make any amendment, directly always speaking of Prabhupada, always speaking of Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta, always speaking of Prabhupada, they are eternal Parshad of Prabhupada. Follow? Not all. If everybody, somebody wanted to, those who all taken Harinam Diksha, all Parshad, foolish number one you are. You are foolish number one. Not that. Somebody was there in bonded condition, they get free, by the mercy of Prabhupada, try to do something. They can try their best to do something. But anyway, if you find that they are deviated from Prabhupada, they are not Nitya Parshad of Prabhupada. 100%. I can promise and speak. 100%. Nitya Parshad is not the symptom of Nitya Parshad. Nitya Parshad means he already sell unto the Lord. What is sold? If my life is sold unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada, if you are going to cut my head, still I am not going to change my Siddhanta. The same example I can give. When Sanatana Gosai took decision to give life under the wheel of Jagannath Rath Yatra, at the time of Rath Yatra, Mahaprabhu became very angry. Mahaprabhu speaking, Haridas, you see the consideration. You see the consideration of this, you know, Sanatana. Well, what, Prabhu, what happens? If I keep any property deposit with you, you have your right to spend it? No. Only deposited money, deposited property, you have to give me back. Then why is going to take decision? What happens? Sanatana says, what happens, Prabhu? Don't try to hide. Don't try to hide, Sanatana. I can give my life hundreds of times. If you can show me that if I am going to give life, that I can get Krishna. Mahaprabhu speaking, I can give this life hundreds of times if I can get Krishna. Sanatana, sarir tyage, Krishna nahi paaye. Krishna, you have to do bhajan. Though they are eternal parsad, still Mahaprabhu speaking, Sanatana, if I am going to leave my body, hundreds of times I can leave. If it is sure that I am going to get Krishna, in Vrindavan, in Sadhu Samaj, you are speaking. Agar gardan deke Krishna milta hai, to obhi Maharaj sasta hai. You know? Gardan, you know? Gardan deke agar Krishna mil raha hai, to obhi Maharaj samjho ki bahut cheap hai. Itna cheap market? How you say? So Krishna is not so cheap. So Mahaprabhu speaking, your body is not my property. You have no right to speak and think separate way. You have no right to think and speak separate way. How dare you taking decision? Then Mahaprabhu, you know, going to embrace Sanatan, making his body all like previous, golden complexion, very nice, embracing all scavenges, you know, gone. All blood and, you know, bad blood all coming. Sanatana took decision, why Mahaprabhu every day coming and embracing me, kissing me? It's not good, I cannot bear. Better I can leave my body. Who are you to leave your body? I can explain the total darshan of Prabhupad. How Prabhupad explaining in front of those who are specially going for preaching. Otherwise they can become totally failure, fall into the ocean of material, you know, world. Big problem. So you see, I can again explain something day by day, gradually I can go on explaining. Tatte nukampam susamikshamanam bhunyanu eva atmakrita vipakam ridbhagbhavirvidodhat namaste jiveto bhakti pade shadai bhag. Any question, any doubt? No? I am speaking about him also. Somebody, so many people criticizing you. In old age, going foreign country? Old man? Maharaj laughing. Maharaj laughing, let them criticize. Maharaj going there. And, you know, preaching nicely. Maharaj never speak any sahajya siddhanta. I heard Harikatha of Maharaj, I was very inspired. Very nice. He never. Maharaj was not Sahajiya. Maharaj was very strict. Maharaj used to say, you have to get quality through Guru Seva. I cannot find any qualified person. I don't like to elaborate it, this is a very bad point. So, very nice. Vanchakalpa Dharvasya Kya Pasindh Bhavacha Patitanang Pavanam Bhavishnam.